Welcome to our spring concert. So glad that you could come out with us tonight as we celebrate the accomplishments of all of these students since the beginning of the year. And we are very fortunate to have Dr. Alex Chan, just graduated from University of Maryland with his PhD in piano, accompanying us tonight. And what you're hearing now is a combination of the concert choir and the honors chorus. And when we went to Orlando, we put these two groups together. And so they've been working together and developing quite nicely. And so we hope you enjoy the presentation that they have for you tonight. Welcome.
Trimmed and burning, sick, and he raised the dead. The manna fell from heaven, and the people were fed. He said, destroy this temple and tear it down. But in 3 days I'll come out of the ground. Oh, tell me where they lay him, if you please. Show me the tomb and I will believe. Let me see the nail scars in his head, and I will believe in the Son of Man. Oh, Thomas was the one who doubted the most. When Jesus appeared, he thought he was a ghost. But the scars in his hands and the wounds in his feet made Thomas confess, Lord, I believe. Tell me where they lay him, if you please. Show me the tomb and I will believe. Let me see the nail scars in his head, and I will believe in the Son of Man. What he said, destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will rise again.
Hallelujah.
Do you believe?
Do you believe?
Do you believe? Do you believe what he said? Destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will rise again. Yeah. Tell me where they laid him, if you please. Show me the tomb, and I will believe. Let me see the nail scars in his head, then I will believe in the Son of Man. Oh, tell me where they laid him, if you please. Show me the tomb, and I will believe. Let me see the nail scars in his head, then I will believe in the Son of Man.
Troubles of the world, the world, the troubles of the world, the world, the world. Soon I will be done with the troubles of the world, going home to live with God.
I want to meet my Jesus.
I want
to meet my Jesus.
I want
to meet my Jesus.
I'm going to live with God.
I want
to meet my Jesus.
I want
to meet my Jesus.
I want
to meet my Jesus.
I'm going to live with God.
So as an educator, particularly a music educator, we try to give the students various experiences. Those of you who've been with us throughout the year, we started in the fall with each group singing as a separate ensemble. Then we combined together for Christmas. Of course, we had the whole gospel concert experience. But you notice with this concert, there are no soloists, and that's on purpose. Because our goal is to solidify that whole idea of choral singing. And so from Beethoven to Mozart to the spiritual, to the gospels, to art songs, it's very important to give the students a wide range of experiences with different literature. Now, this next piece is probably going to be something that, if you're over 50, raise your hand. Yeah, me too. Yeah, so I don't know how much of our students actually heard this song before we started to learn it, but it's a throwback. And at a certain point in time in the history of our country, it had a lot of meaning to a lot of people, very sentimental meaning. But nevertheless, we do have some old souls in the choir, so I know we have a few people that like to go back and listen to the classics, and they surprise me sometimes with their choice of music. But anyway, we wanted to just diversify tonight and just to share a little different type of experience for the students. And so we hope you enjoy this classic song.
Thank you.
So while the other choirs are coming, we just want to take a moment and just acknowledge the fact that this is indeed the last concert in this format for our seniors. And so we want to just take a moment and just to honor them. And one of the ways that we honor them is that we have a tradition, and that is we bless them. And so this final song is really not a performance, but it's more of a prayer. It's a prayer that we're going to sing. And so the reason why we're bringing all of the other students on is because one of the things we realize is that, you know, this program can't be successful without the support of the students who grow to the place where they've been in the program for 4 years, and they become role models and they become examples for the others. I remember when I was in college, and I was on the basketball team, and you know, we had a rough time with the coach in the beginning, and we didn't understand his methods, and we didn't like some of his ways. But then something happened. We started winning, and then all of a sudden, you know, we really became close to the coach. And so new recruits would come, and when new recruits would come, we didn't really have to train them because the peer pressure was there. Well, the coach didn't really have to train them because the positive peer pressure was there, because those of us who were already there would say, hey, no, man, we don't do it that way. This is the way we do it here. If you want to play, you got to do it like this. You know, when we run, you have to run like this. When we work out, you have to work out like this. And I remember one time, they're used to this. I remember one time, the coach, it was Thanksgiving, and he took me aside, and he gave me about, I don't know, maybe $200. He said, listen, there was a kid, right? He was from Georgia, and he said, Take him home with you. He doesn't have anywhere to go for Thanksgiving. You know, you have a car. Take him back to Maryland with you. Here's some money, whatever he needs, whatever you all want to do. Have a good time. But he said, when you're riding down the road, you better talk to him. Because if he doesn't get his attitude right, I'm shipping his behind back to Georgia. And I thought that was very interesting, because he deputized me as a captain of the team and as a leader of the team to help him coach the others. Well, that's what you see here. Seniors, if you're a senior in chamber choir, step down to the floor. What you see here, what you see here are assistant coaches. These are my assistant coaches. They have been with me, many of them, most of them, for 4 years. They, you know, they put up with me. I mean, you know, I know you, some of y'all, you know, I show you the nice side. But sometimes they see the whole person, and they're still here. They haven't left, and that's relationship, right? And relationship only happens when you spend time with one another. And the unique thing about the choir is that we spend time with each other every year, whereas if you take a math class, you may know that math teacher and have a good relationship. But I've watched them grow up. I remember, yeah. Yeah. And so they're being cool, but we're all having a hard time with this, you know. This is a moment, right? And you value that person that's in front of you, right? You, that relationship that's in front of you. These are not just voices that you see here. These are relationships. Relationships with me and relationships with one another. Some of these students met in choir, and now they're still really good friends 4 years later. So this is something that is just very unique, what we've been able to do here. And I just wanted to say publicly, okay, thank you for don't do that. Thank you. Thank you so much. It's been just a joy, you know, teaching you, making music with you. Y'all sing my songs so well. And look, when I bring out a new song, they're excited about it. I just can't get over the fact that young people would want to sing an old man's music. But they're excited about it. And so I wanted to say publicly, in front of your parents, in front of all of the audience, and in front of all these other choir members here, you have provided great leadership. And just like you're standing on the shoulders of others who have gone on, those who come after you will be standing on your shoulders. And so I honor you. We bless you with this song. And I want everybody just to give a big round of applause to recognize all these seniors. So as we sing this last song, this is not so much as a performance, but it is our way to bless you as you go on your way. We want to speak a blessing over your life, that the Lord would bless you, that the Lord would keep you, that he would lift up the light of his countenance upon you, and that he would make his face to shine upon you, that he would give you peace. And, you know, I want you to know, you know, that this is always home, right? Your counsel is always home. And so, you know, somebody else will move into your position, but they will never take your place. All right? Thank you all so much for coming. Good night. Thank you. Thank you all so much.